There we go. So hello, beautiful Louise Howard.
Hello, gorgeous Susie. How are you?
I'm so good and so delighted to have you here today to get to speak to you again, because I love speaking to you generally about pretty much anything and, and everything as we do. So Louise, I have worked with Louise as a coach myself, which was a really, really great experience back when, I can't remember, it was pre-COVID maybe. Pre-COVID. I think this is going to be like set as an era in time, you know, like Stone Age or
the beginning of the end.
Yeah, totally. So Louise is obviously a coach, but Louise has all this, like, so many different incredible teachings, learnings, things behind her belt. Do you want to share a little bit about who you are and what you do?
Yeah, thank you for that beautiful introduction. It's always a pleasure to speak to you. Beautiful soul that you are. I'm Louise Howard. I live in the northwest of England. I suppose, like many people, I had my awakening in 2012, where I was in a toxic job and just hated it. I was physically ill. I was anorexic. I suppose that was my dark night of the soul. And then I went on a big journey. So for the last 10 years, that was 10 years ago, I trained as a holistic therapist. So I've been doing that for the past sort of 9 years. And more recently, so I've given that up recently, and I trained probably about 4 years ago as a holistic coach and human design reader. So I'm a true manifesting generator. I'm into everything. It's easier for me to tell you what I haven't trained in, but yeah. At the moment, I'm super all about the human design and coaching to help people integrate that into their lives, really. So yeah, that's me.
Amazing. Yeah, I love that. I love this journey that you've been on. And I'm sure that so many people can resonate with that this healing journey of experiencing something really difficult, as you mentioned there, your job and the anorexia, and how we discover these things just at the right time when we need them.
I always call it it was a miracle, because I was never into anything spiritual, esoteric or anything like that. And then somebody at work gave me a book on Reiki, and I had been for Reiki 10 years before, never thought anything of it. And she gave me a book by Lorna Byrne called Stairways to Heaven, which is all about her journey seeing angels. And again, I wasn't into anything. I didn't understand any of that. Sorry, that's my phone beeping. I didn't understand any of that. And I read the book, read both books, and I went for some Reiki, and then everything changed. And then I met someone else in work who was on the spiritual path, and they gave me more books to read. So it's like the spiritual path kind of landed at my feet and went, here you go, here's the way out. And for me, it was quite miraculous, really, how it all happened. But and then that's what I did. That's what I found my way out through the spiritual path. So, yeah.
Wow. Amazing. Amazing. Obviously, you're here today to kind of touch on human design and go through that. But I think it is, you know, it's really, like you say, I actually had Reiki healing a million years before really, really got into it. And, you know, it didn't have that much of an impact back then. I can't even really properly remember the first, you know, first session. But then a friend reintroduced me to Reiki when I was struggling with depression and anxiety and chronic illness. And then that really was just, you know, it's that right timing, isn't it?
Yeah, totally. You know, I think I didn't know anything about it. I knew I needed help, but I knew it wasn't nothing wrong with going to a doctor at all. I'm not saying there's anything wrong with that, but I knew it wasn't that I needed. I knew there was something else that I needed. And then I found this girl. And so, yeah, timing is perfect. And I think sometimes we were, you know, the timing just happens and it unfolds. And then you look back and then you go, oh, my God. Or there's the opposite version of it where you're pushing and striving to get to somewhere, but it's not going to happen because the timing isn't right. Yeah. It is all about timing. It's so super important. Yeah. Mm. When the timing is right, it'll happen. You can't really stop it, I don't think. Like you and me both found Reiki at that same time. It was meant to be. It was going to happen, you know, and the timing was right. So it did. So, yeah.
Yeah, absolutely. And working with the right teacher, healer, you know.
Oh yeah,
I think it's so important. So human design, I it's definitely something I want to dive more into and learn more and more about. And every time, you know, I listen to podcasts about it, or I've had two readings with you, and then follow your work that you share as well, and you've, you know, done bits and pieces in the membership as well. So tell us a bit about kind of what is human design. For starters, what is human design?
Human design, basically, I suppose it's a chart that you get from your date, time and place of birth. And it really is, it's often called the science of the aura or the science of differentiation. I struggle with that word. But I think that's so a perfect way of putting it, because it's like, it's you. It tells you exactly who you are, how to use your energy, what your strengths are, how to make decisions. It allows you to be you. And that's the thing that I find most when people have readings, they're like, oh, I kind of always knew that, but I thought there was something wrong with me. Yeah. Or I always knew that, but I was desperately trying to fit into what some business coaches, you know, nothing wrong with business coaches, but some people are telling you how to run a business, and that's not the way for you, you know. Mm-hmm. It's how you can embrace being more you and being okay with that. Because most of the time people are not okay with that, and they're trying to do something else, and that causes resistance. Yeah. And that means that you're going to struggle. If you're struggling in life somewhere, then you're fighting against what's meant to be.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So it's a chart with a ton of info. There's so much information in a human design chart. That can help you to just, it's all about ease and flow. How do you allow the universe to send you what is meant for you easier and quicker, mm-hmm. without less hassle or struggle?
I love that. I think it is, you know, there, once you have a human design reading and find out a bit more about yourself, there definitely is, and I think, you know, I said this on a podcast that I recorded recently about kind of embracing your uniqueness and, mm-hmm. You know, fully stepping into yourself. But there is that sudden realization of like permission, as you said, like that permission just to be yourself. And okay, well, maybe that isn't for me. Maybe I do work differently from other people. Maybe I do see the world in a different way. Mm-hmm. And once you have that permission, it's like, it's that light bulb moment, isn't it? Of, oh, wow.
It really is. I mean, it changed my life so much. You know, I then went on to train in it and become a reader, because I was like, oh my God, people need to know. When I realized, I think the biggest thing for me was, as a manifesting generator, that we can have our fingers in lots of pies. Like, I've always had two businesses on the go, or three at one point. And I was always into lots of things. You know, I'd go to a yoga class, and then 2 months later I was on a yoga teacher training course. Yeah. And everyone was like, what are you doing that for? You spread yourself too thin. No, actually, for a manifesting generator, to do it any other way than that is going to really cripple you, because that's not the way you operate. And when I was given permission to do that and let everyone go, oh, you should just have one business and do one thing, and go, okay, yeah, and let them, you know, because people can't handle manifesting generators really in general. But when I let them have their opinion, but I was like, it's okay, because I'm okay doing what I'm doing, and I'm happy. The more you embrace that, the more freeing it is, the more easier it is, and the more happier you are, because you're not going around with all this mental exhaustion going, oh, I shouldn't be doing this, but I really want to do this, and blah, blah, blah. So yeah, it's freedom. You know, it's about that freedom to be you and do things and let things come to you in a much easier way when you learn how to do that. Really does. It's crazy.
Yeah, amazing. So obviously you mentioned you're a manifesting generator. What are the different what do you call them?
Types.
Simple word.
Types. There's five types. So manifesting generators and generators, they are the majority of the population are manifesting generators and generators. They're energy beings. With manifestors are a little bit, they're quite rare, and then we've got projectors, like your good self, reflectors. So they're the five, reflectors being the rarest, because they they're kind of, yeah, they have a different process of using their energy because they are, yeah, lunar beings rather than solar beings. So yeah,
interesting. Mm-hmm. And is there like is there a way that you can give us like a little brief like tiny bit on each one, or yeah. Is it
so manifesting generators really are here to kind of if you talk about the strategy, they're here to respond to the sacred. So it's all about doing what lights them up. Manifesting generators really are the types that are here to have the fingers in lots of pies. They'll be into this thing 1 minute. They'll be like, no, I never want to do that again. That's the worst thing I can think about. And then I want to do this. And it's all about, for manifesting generators, the strategy, what we call the strategy, is responding to the sacral. So do I really want to do this? Does this light me up? And manifesting generators really can have two different businesses and can go off and be a yoga teacher and can then come back and go, I don't want to do that anymore and do something else, you know? And they're not linear. They miss out bits, you know. They go A, F, B, Z, K, you know. It's all over the place in manifesting generators. Generators are similar in they respond. If generators really, they often have a lot of boundary karma, so they go around doing things that other people want them to do, or the shoulds, because that's how they've been, you know, conditioned. So really, again, for generators, the same strategy is tuning into what they love and letting go of the no's, the things that feel heavy and hard. Same for manifesting generators. But so, yeah, it's all about generators doing what lights them up, because that lovely energy of they can go all day when they're doing something that lights them up, and that energy is going to bring other people to them. Manifestors, typically in history, they would have been the kings and queens and rulers of the world. The biggest aura, manifestors have the biggest aura. Mm-hmm. And they're the only ones that can get an urge. So manifestors get urged to do something and then they can go and do that. So everyone else has to wait for something. So, you know, manifesting generators wait for a sacral response. Manifestors, yeah, they get an urge to do something, but they must tell other people. Their strategy is to inform, because they have a tendency to get an urge and then off they go, but no one else knows what the heck they're up to.
Yeah. I feel like I've maybe got a bit of that in me as well.
Yeah, I'm so jealous of manifestors, because I would love to be able to just get up and do what I want to do, but
yeah.
I have an element of that, so I have to be really careful that I don't do that, because if the sacral's not on board, it's not going to work.
Yeah.
So manifestors, yeah, biggest auras. And for them, it's, you know, some people are going to get them and some people won't. Mm-hmm. You know, if you're a manifestor, maybe in business, and some people are really going to tune into that bigness and that, you know, the way that you do things, and other people aren't. So for manifestors, it's really important to learn that some people will get you and some people won't. And that's perfectly fine.
Mm-hmm.
Reflectors. Mm-hmm. Reflectors are they're basically non-energy beings. They're the rarest, so they don't have any of the energy centers. So if you look at a chart, you've got little shapes, energy centers, either colored in or not colored in, but they don't have, reflectors have no energy centers colored in. So they really have, they pick up the energy of everyone around them. They have the greatest potential for wisdom out of all of the types because of their openness in their chart. And when we talk about openness, that's the energy centers just not being colored in. So they take in the energy of others and then they amplify it. You know, they can really feel that. And their strategy really is to go through, wait through the lunar cycle. So they have to really kind of tune into where they are every on the 28-day cycle or 29-day cycle, where what's happening for them on certain days, because as the planets change, so will they change. Very like a chameleon, really, reflectors. Super interesting reflectors, but like I say, only 1% of the population, which is quite a lot of people. But
yeah.
And then projectors, again, non-energy beings, and these are the people that are here to guide the energy beings. They are here to see and not do. Mm-hmm. So projectors have, I always think projectors that I know have the most beautiful energy, and they are here to really say to the energy beings, guys, why don't you try doing it this way? Why don't you try doing it a better way? They can really, their aura is, you know, they can really see into the aura of other people, and they're really here to guide and make things better for them. And they have to watch their energy, because they're non-energy beings. They don't have the sacral defined. So Yeah, I think projectors are the newest of the types. They're here because we got past a point in evolution where it wasn't just about, you know, surviving past 30. You know, we had a choice of what we do with our lives. We had a choice to connect with our soul mm-hmm. and serve a purpose. And projectors really are here to help us to do that. So, yeah, in a nutshell,
they are. The
Yeah.
Amazing. Yeah, no, it is. It's so fascinating. And if somebody wanted to grab their own chart, where would they get that from?
I always go to jovianarchive.com and you can get your chart there. And Jenna Zoe, who I trained with, you can go to her website as well. I think it's just jennazoe.com and you can do your chart there. So you will need your date, time, and place of birth. A lot of people struggle with the time.
Yeah.
We can kind of get around that. If you've got an idea, it helps, but you will need the time of birth.
Perfect. Cool. And I can pop that in the comments and in the show notes of the podcast as well, so people can do that. Yeah. But what would you say, like, from working with human design then, what's your favorite part of your job? Like, what?
Oh my gosh. I think the favorite part is that part when people go, oh my gosh, I kind of always knew that, but mm-hmm. I've never really embraced it. Or I've always thought that what I was doing was wrong, when actually what they're doing is right. So it's that part of when I do a reading for someone and they suddenly realize, the, like, you know, one lady said, I think the last lady said to me, oh my God, do you know me? I'm like, no, I'm just looking, it's all in your chart. You know, I'm not psychic. I'm not any of those things, but I just love helping people. And this is in my chart as well. So I have the gate of increase in my chart. So I'm all about helping people increase, grow, expand, whether that's in business or spiritually or in life, whatever it is. For me, that is so important. And it's just being able to help people to increase, make life easier, make life better, to give them, help people say, yeah, it's okay to be me, and go out and embrace that and do that more. You know, that is the best part of my job. Absolutely. You know, I just love it.
Amazing. I know definitely for me, and as you mentioned, the cold projector thing about kind of, you know, watching your energy. And I know when I had a reading that you'd picked up on things, there are things such as like adrenal fatigue is quite common, and projectors, and that's something that I'd previously struggled with my past. So it's good to, I think, to have this understanding of ways to kind of support yourself mentally, emotionally, the way you work. Like, there's so many different facets to the human design.
It's just amazing, really. I look at my chart quite often, and I remember that, you know, I look at the gates. There's some gates that are more important than others, and the channels. And I look at my chart, and I go, when I go off track a little bit, I go, hey, remember, this is who you are. You know, remember, you know, you might have the channel of the alpha, which is someone who's here to, you know, be in charge of a big tribe of people. And often when I say that, and I say, you know, are you really embracing that? They might have a tribe, but they're not really kind of embracing the fact that they're the leader of that tribe. Or they might have the gate of talent, where they're super talented at most things and they're in a point to get to mastery and they need support along the way. So it just helps people really embrace those, you know, most what you were put here for a reason. We all have, I believe, one, I've heard this said before, we all have one, one goal is to serve.
Yeah.
But it's like a branch of a tree. We all have our own unique way of doing that, you know, and human design just goes, here, there you go. That's how you use your energy. And that's what you're really good at. And that's what you want to embrace a little bit more. And it's the more that we can embrace as spiritual beings, our uniqueness and our wholeness and our perfectness and our gifts and talents, then my God, and we need it more now than ever. You know, we need that more now than ever. So it's super important. Really is, and that's why I love it.
Amazing. So if somebody wanted to grab a reading from you, how would they go about doing that?
I'm on Instagram mainly. So you can find me on Instagram at Human Design UK, and there's a link to book a reading on there. And I also have a website called LouiseHowardCoaching.com, and there's all the coaching option different. Once you've had a reading and you want coaching to help you integrate that into your life or business, all of the information is on the website there. So,
yeah. I love it. You've got some great blogs and support and things as well there.
Yeah, I try and do lots of blogs on various different topics, mainly to help people in business integrate their human design. So yeah, that's what I'm really passionate about.
Love it. Amazing. So as well as human design, what else do you do to support yourself kind of mentally, emotionally, physically? What tools do you pull on?
I'm a student of A Course in Miracles, which I love. So every day starts with the lesson of the day, whatever that may be. Sometimes that goes in, sometimes it doesn't. But meditation, massive. I spent the last 10 years as a holistic therapist. So for me, massage, reflexology, anything like that is a massive, it's a must for me. I've missed it. I've not had any massages for a little while. I've just had some this weekend. I'm like, oh my God, what am I doing?
Yeah.
So that is really, really important for me, is that time out to do all of that. And I'm quite into sound healing as well at the moment, and anything I can get my hands on really to help, anything like that. But always A Course in Miracles, meditation in the morning, that's how I start my day always, and a bit of journaling as well. So yeah,
all of those. Love it. Yeah, I mean, yeah, you could spend hours, couldn't you? I'm loving all the like sound healing, okay, massage, reflexology, aromatherapy. Aromatherapy is something else that you create products.
That's my other manifesting generator business, a business called Louisa B Apothecary. Louisa B was my great grandma. So I make a range of aromatherapy products, candles, crystal candles, and bath salts and balms and all sorts of things. So
energy cleaning sprays. If you're watching this on IGTV or YouTube, you will see me holding it. Just, I love this in my office. Your smudge energy cleaning spray is so good.
All of that kind of stuff. So yeah, that's, I've got lots of new things in store for next year as well. So yeah, that keeps me busy, especially now.
Amazing. So kind of, my podcast is obviously called Be Free, and I know you've mentioned that human design gives you that sense of, you know, discovering freedom, but what makes you feel free, or what does freedom look like for you as a person? I'd love to know.
I think freedom for me is, I'm so grateful that I have a business now, like that if I am organized, which most of the time I am, I can, you know, nip off and go for a walk if I want to, or if I'm feeling really tired, I can go for a nap, or, you know, if I'm not working with clients, obviously. But freedom for me is I'm in charge of it all. I'm in charge of my business. I'm in charge. So I have that freedom to go off and do whatever I want, whenever I want. I can create whatever I want, whenever I want. And this is, you know, we're all here to create. We're all here to create whatever it is that we want. And we can all do this. So for me, freedom is that, what do I want to create next? And having nothing in the way of that. And that's again why I love human design, because it says, well, this, I know how I run my business, I know how I operate. So freedom comes for me in accepting that. Freedom comes accepting that I may receive more, be more open-palmed in my receiving. I don't have to be specific to manifest. I don't have to do any of that. So it's that freedom to go, okay, what do I want to create? How do I want my life to live life? And then the ability to go ahead and do that. Mm-hmm. And there's nothing in the way of that. There's nothing. And this comes from many years, you know, lots of mindset work. I'm not putting anything in the way of that. And physically, there isn't a job, or there isn't a person, or, you know, there isn't anything really in the way of that. And that's what freedom is for me, is being able to say, this is what I want to create. And that's, I'm going to go and do that. And then maybe I'll change my mind, but I have a freedom. I've got the freedom to do that. And that's perfectly okay.
Love that. Yeah. The freedom of choice, isn't it? You know, and I think we can so often feel stuck, that, you know, that we're kind of helpless or disempowered, that we don't have that freedom of choice. But actually, in so many aspects, there's always a choice, isn't there? And the mindset plays a huge part in that. I know you supported me with that, with your coaching, and the mindset aspect of it.
Mindset, I mean, for me, mindset's everything. That's what human design helps us do. It helps you to decondition from the, you know, this the person that our mindset tells us we should be, or, you know, how we should be doing things. When actually, when we clear that, human design goes, no, it's this way, and it allows us to clear out that clutter that says, no, the old way is the way, you know. It allows us to free yourself up to follow that new path. That's what mindset does. And human design is a way of showing you how to do that. That's, again, another reason why I love it. Yeah, we can all create. It's all doable.
Love it. Amazing. So beautiful. Louise has already got a masterclass for us in the Spirit and Soul membership. So if you are a member, you can go back and check that out. It was, I'm just looking here, April 2021, Embracing Uniqueness. So you can go back, check out that masterclass. If you want to join the membership, you only have until the end of this month. So if you're listening to this, this is November 2021. So the doors will be closing to the membership the end of this month. So you can come join us, check out Louise's session in there. And that will be the last chance to grab 2021 pricing as well. So you may want to do that. So you can check out the links in the show notes. And Louise, you've already mentioned kind of how people can kind of connect with you. So yeah, it's the best way, as you mentioned, kind of Instagram.
Yeah, Instagram. Website. I don't really use Facebook as much these days. So Instagram. Mm-hmm. And, you know, feel free to message me if you've got any questions about just, you know, I am on Facebook. You can always drop me a little message. I'm always happy to say hello. But yeah, Instagram, PM me on there, or just follow all my stuff there. Yeah.
Yeah, Ace, I love it, because yeah, you do some great teachings and kind of little divine downloads and live sharings and
yeah, I pop in whenever I feel inspired. So yeah, divine download days happen.
Love it, amazing. And is there anything else you want to add for anyone that's listening or watching?
I just think anyone who's watching, who maybe, you know, isn't in a great place at the moment, know that you can change that. Whether you're stressed or anxious, you have the ability to shift out of that space, because both me and Susie have been in those places before, and we're not in those places anymore. So if you're not feeling great, then, you know, it's all doable, and seek help. Yeah, seek the help that you feel guided to seek help.
Thank you. And I know I can feel it in my heart already as we're just recording this and it hasn't even gone out, that's really going to hit home for someone. That message of just going and seeking support. And like Louise mentioned, you know, if any questions or anything's come up for anyone throughout this, please do feel free to reach out to either of us. We're kind of very open and you know, there to kind of support as well.
Absolutely.
So amazing. Thank you so much. And I'll look forward to another reading, because each time it gets deeper and deeper and more inspiring and interesting. And I love how I think you take something each time you have a reading, and different ways to implement it at different stages in your life as well.
Absolutely. There's a lot of information in a reading. It's the best way to do it, actually. So, but yeah, thank you for having me. It's always beautiful to speak to you. Appreciate
it. Me too. And we will speak soon.
Yeah. Take care.
Bye.